Movies about sports and champions have always been among Hollywood's biggest winners. Rocky proved it when it went the distance at the box office and the Academy Awards. Whether highlighting the thrill of victory is in MASH, or the agony of defeat in The Great White Hope, competition is the keynote in sports movies, whether it's deadly serious, as in The Hustler,
You Break,
or comical, as in John Goldfarb, Please Come Home. Or musical in Gentlemen Prefer Blondes.
Can't play tennis, my golf's a menace. I just can't do the Australian crawl.
Okay, the next one's coming right between your eyes.
From little leaguers like Tatum O'Neill to big leaguers like Bob Hope.
If you see anybody, look sick.
Hollywood covers the entire world of sports with favorite stars like Sylvester Stallone, Kirk Douglas, Robbie Benson, Walter Matthau, and Paul Newman. So take a sporting chance and join us as That's Hollywood shows you why everybody loves a winner.
Americans love a winner.
Sports movies give the audience the chance to root for the underdog, and Rocky was the underdog to beat them all. Its star and writer, a total unknown, Sylvester Stallone, beat on Hollywood doors for over 2 years. And then, when he won an offer of $250,000 for the script, he refused unless he could star as Rocky.
What?
How about you give us your order?
Get out of here! Don't you ever interrupt me while I'm conducting business. You lay off that pet shop game. Women weaken legs.
Yeah, but I really like this girl, you know?
Well, let her train you!
Okay, no more fooling around.
Okay, I hit it.
Women weaken legs, huh?
The gamble paid off. Stallone won his fight and superstardom. Rocky won an Oscar for Best Picture and became the most successful sports movie ever made. In The Great White Hope, the underdog had the whole white race against him.
You may not be aware of it yet, but a very large, very black migration is in progress. They're coming from the fields down south, filling up the slums. And I am talking about hundreds of thousands, maybe millions soon. Millions of ignorant Negroes rapidly massing together. Now, we cannot allow the image of this man to go on impressing and exciting these people.
I'm only a sports promoter, Mr. Dixon.
He read the writing on the door, Pop. Go on.
Well, if he were less of a hero to them, after his next engagement, let's say,
you'd make it worth his while not to win the fight, you mean?
I think I've said what I mean.
Lay down already, will you? You won't have a head left. You hear me? This round, you understand? You'll go down and stay there. You hear me?
The Great White Hope was based on the first real-life black heavyweight champion, Jack Johnson. After starring in the Pulitzer Prize-winning play, James Earl Jones repeated his role on the screen. Ironically, even though the play was about boxing, there were no fights in the stage version. As successful and dramatic as the play was, the movie showed what the Broadway version could only talk about. As a result, Jones, who had never done any boxing before, had to train for months so that spectacular fight scenes like this one would look authentic. In The Bad News Bears, Walter Matthau cons Tatum O'Neill into joining his little league team.
They reach their peak athletically about that age. Probably haven't picked up a ball in 2 years anyway.
Give my love to your mom. Don't be such a stranger.
Hey, Boilermaker.
Yeah?
Got my curve breaking 2.5 feet.
Oh, yeah?
Then you have been practicing, huh? Now, don't give me no baloney about a curve breaking 2.5 feet, though.
For how much?
$10.
Make it 20.
You got a bet.
Quite a job for an 11-year-old actress who not only couldn't pitch, but didn't even like baseball.
Okay, the next one's coming right between your eyes.
Damon Runyon was a true sports legend. He didn't pitch or box or race, but his stories about the characters of the sports world became top movies like Sorrowful Jones, starring Bob Hope.
Stand by, I'll see if the coast is clear. And if you see anybody, look sick.
Hope was the perfect choice for Runyon's racetrack humor in this story that was made into 3 different movies.
Hey. Say, did you see a horse get off the elevator?
A horse?
Yeah, I lost my horse, you hear?
All right.
Well, I'd like to get excited.
I'm not excited. Easy. Maybe he went out to get a drink of water. He'll come right back. They all come back.
Yeah,
we see them around here all the time. Pink ones, green ones, blue ones.
Are you a patient here?
No, I'm a doctor.
Yeah, I'd like a horse.
Why don't you step into my office? You're going to be all right.
There, you see? Nurse!
Another farcical look at sports involves Richard Crenna and Peter Ustinov in John Goldfarb, Please Come Home.
Goldfarb, good Jewish Bedouin.
Well, he also happens to be an American citizen, and while the American government sincerely regrets the manner of his arrival in your kingdom, we must insist on his immediate return to the United States.
Goldfarb, choose freedom. Remain in asylum.
I beg your pardon?
If Falsio beat Notre Dame, he may go home if he wish. This is free country.
Oh, I see.
If, however, Fauzio is defeated by Notre Dame,
Your Majesty,
Goldfarb goes straight to Moscow.
Off screen, this game caused a legal incident when Notre Dame tried to prevent the film from being shown. The university lost the suit and the audience won the fun.
Camel.
Any of you fellows know the Statue of Liberty play? Hmm?
What's up, huh?
They roll up some points, okay? Second half of the game, we stick him in. We get odds from him. We bet the other half of the money. We clean up.
That's very good thinking, Captain.
Yeah, it sounds good to me.
Oh, and I had another idea. I think we should have some plays. You know, usually in football, if you have some organized plays...
Well, if you don't mind, I took the liberty.
Oh, you? Oh.
I drew up about 7 or 8 plays.
Oh, these are good.
I think that's about all this bunch can handle.
Oh, very good. Yes, oh, very, very good. What are these little arrows?
Sometimes a sports segment can become the high point in comedy or drama in a movie that has nothing to do with athletics. Example, this hilarious off-the-wall football scene in MASH.
He runs like a rabbit. We can't stop him.
Yeah, I remember him from the pros. They call him Superbug. He had 1 year with the Rams before the Army
got
him.
Well, we can't do anything with him in there.
But what are we gonna...
You gotta come in now. We can't wait until the second half.
No, we gotta stick to our strategy. But the first thing you guys have to do is get him out of the ball game.
This was the kind of offbeat humor and oddball characters that made MASH one of the biggest comedy hits of all time. The movie was so successful, it spun off one of the longest-running Emmy Award-winning TV shows in history. James Coburn, Susan Anton, Robbie Benson, and Paul Newman prove everybody loves a winner.
Honey, you hurt yourself.
Sports are very much on Jane Russell's mind. Indoor sports, that is.
I can't play tennis, my golf's a menace. I just can't do the Australian crawl. And I'm no better at volleyball. Ain't there anyone here for love? Sweet love, ain't there anyone here for love? I'm apathetic and non-athletic. Can't keep up in a marathon. I need some shoulder to lean upon and a couple of arms to hold me. Ain't there anyone here for love?
When Gentlemen Prefer Blondes was transferred from the stage musical to film, this song was added to provide the visual attractions of male beefcake for the women in the audience.
I like big muscles and red corpuscles. I like a beautiful hunk of man, but I'm no physical culture fan. Ain't there anyone here for love, sweet love? Ain't there anyone? Ain't there anyone?
Love starts in strange and mysterious ways in the movies. In a sports film, romance can begin with a crash. In The Racers, Kirk Douglas did much of his own dangerous driving through the narrow streets of Europe, but he handled all the romance with co-star Bella Darby.
You want to see me?
I want to tell you how sorry I am. And to thank you for avoiding Bogey.
Look, I avoided him only because hitting anything that size would have been sure disaster. Not that the result was any better, but well, let's not get sentimental.
If there's anything I can do...
How would you like to buy me a new car, huh? A late model 4.2 Verano right from the factory? Only 7 million lira.
7 million?
Yeah. And if you can't afford it, maybe one of your rich friends...
Darling, I beg your pardon.
This is Signor Borghese, Paul. Consalum, director of our theater.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I witnessed your accident. Congratulations on being alive.
Thanks.
Supper at the casino, Nicole. I'll drop by the hotel and come for you later.
Don't bother, Paul. Signor Borghese has offered to drive me.
That's most kind of you. I brought you this. I thought you might need it. Good night, Signor Borghese. Better luck to you in the future.
Of course, if you have other plans.
No other plans. Well, as long as we don't take Bogey.
You break.
The Hustler gave movie audiences a look at a different kind of sports arena as Paul Newman faces old pro Jackie Gleason. Since Newman's only previous experience with pool was racking up balls in his college days, Paul was coached by technical advisor Willie Moscone, a world champion who also performed some of the trick shots in the film. But Jackie Gleason needed no such tutoring. He was already a lifelong enthusiast and one of the best pool sharks in show business.
You left enough. Six in the corner.
Oh, he is great. Gee, that old fat man. Look at the way he moves, like a dancer.
12, cross-eyed.
And those fingers, them chubby fingers. That stroke. It's like he's playing a violin or something.
Your shot.
You miss.
Well, you don't leave much when you miss, do you, Batman?
That's what the game's all about.
Two ball, side park. Very good shot. You know, I got a hunch, fat man. I got a hunch it's me from here on in. One ball, corner pocket. I mean, that ever happened to you? And all of a sudden you feel like you can't miss? Because I dreamed about this game, fat man. I dreamed about this game every night on the road. Five ball. You know, this is my table, man. I own it.
Producers of movies about athletics have unique casting problems. The stars must look the part physically and, as in the case of Susan Anton in Golden Girl, must convince audiences she can compete. She obviously convinces James Coburn.
And I looked over at Janie Knute, keeping me from third place, and all of a sudden, like a shot of adrenaline, it swept over me.
You got a second win.
Oh, no. I looked over at that sweet little girl, and I hated her. I hated her. It really shook me, you know, because I didn't want to beat her anymore. I wanted to destroy her. And when I took her in that dip finish, oh, I relished it.
Don't equate the killer instinct with knowing who you are.
Yeah, so you telling me that I'm basically a sweet little girl and not mean at all.
Listen, it's as natural to an athlete to want to destroy her opponent as put on a pair of track shoes. That's all.
Do an axel.
No!
Did you hear what I said? I said you're going to do an axel.
Nick, what are you doing?
We're going to go around again, and when we're straight cut, you're going to do an axel.
Shut up!
You're gutless.
Can't you do it without the TV cameras?
You're sure a better skater than you are a fighter.
In Ice Castles, producers had another casting problem. Lynn Holly Johnson was a champion skating star who had no acting experience. She astounded audiences in her portrayal of a blinded skater trying to make a comeback with the help of Robbie Benson. This is the magic of the sports movies. Strong emotional stories about competitors overcoming all obstacles. In the film Breaking Away, not only are the heroes underdogs, but so is the bicycle.
Because you don't have to ride it.
Well, I mean, you don't have to ride it either, Dave. We're not going to beg you.
We may plead, but we would never beg.
Get off, Cyril. At least we got invited. I'm just going to take it back.
Oh, you seem relieved, Mike. What's the matter? Don't you think we can win anymore? Why not?
Maybe those guys are better than us.
Well, maybe they are. But that's the first time I heard you say anything like that.
That's the first time I ever felt that.
All right.
Breaking Away was a real dark horse that no one had ever heard of, with unknown actors and a first-time screenwriter. But it had something audiences everywhere could identify with, refusing to quit no matter how great the odds. And it proved to be a winning combination for those behind the scenes as well as the characters on the screen. Breaking Away broke away at the box office and became an unexpected success, as well as capturing 5 Oscar nominations. Now that's a true winner. Proof that audiences applaud stories of champions who break through, defying everything that stands in their way. That's the spirit of great movies about sports and sports heroes. And that's Hollywood.